This YouTube's on mass, weight, and gravity. Speaking qualitatively, mass is the quantity of matter and it's intrinsic. Weight, however, is a measurement of how much a mass, however kilograms it may be, registers when it's put on a scale. It could be a spring scale, but other kinds of scales would work as well. A spring scale is as good as any. So if we are in a gravitational field, then the mass is going to have weight, and the weight will be m times g. So it's going to depend on what g is, and different planets have different g's. The weight will also depend upon the acceleration of the reference frame that you're in. As we'll see a little bit later, if I'm 100 kilograms and I am standing on a weight on a scale on terra firma, assuming a g equals 10 meters per second per second, my weight is going to be m times g, which is 1,000 newtons. On the other hand, if that scale is on the floor of an elevator and somebody cuts the cable holding the elevator, the scale that I'm standing on will register 0 newtons. W equals 0 newtons, an elevator with cable cut. So let's talk a little bit about the gravitational force, because we need to understand that better. And I did mention this in class. Among other things, Newton figured out that two masses have a force that can be written in closed form that one exerts on the other. And by Newton's third law, the force one exerts on the other is the same in magnitude but the opposite in direction as the force that the other exerts on the first. So here, for example, are the Earth and the Moon, and there is a force of on the Earth by the Moon, shown to the right in this drawing, and conversely, there's a force of the Earth on the Moon. This is the force of the Moon on the Earth. This is the force of the Earth on the Moon. And if they are separated by a distance d from center to center is the way to do this, then the magnitude of these forces is the universal gravitational constant g times the product of the mass of the two bodies, in this case the mass of the Earth and the mass of the Moon, divided by their distance in meters squared. So if you are close to the surface of the Earth, so let's say an object M, not necessarily you, is close to the surface of the Earth, and so here's little m, here's the Earth, there's going to be a force on this mass little m, which in parallel with how we calculated the force of the Moon on the Earth, we would calculate the force of the Earth on this mass by taking the product of the two masses, in this case the little m that's under consideration here, times the mass of the Earth, that's the other mass in the pair here, divided by, well, it's essentially the radius of the Earth squared, separation between the center and this little m close to the surface of the Earth is essentially going to have a separation r sub e from the center of the Earth times the gravitational constant, universal gravitational constant. So we can rewrite that as m times big G times the mass of the Earth divided by the radius squared. Well, we've said before that the weight of an object m, little m, close to the surface of the Earth is m times g, and so therefore we, to be consistent, little g is this combination of constants, big G times the mass of the Earth divided by the radius of the Earth squared. So if we plug in the values, big G, 6.67 times 10 to the minus 11, newton meters squared, kilograms to the minus 2. These units are required to make the force equation dimensionally consistent, times the mass of the Earth, 5.98 times 10 to the 24th kgs, divided by the radius of the Earth, and this is the mean radius of the Earth, 6.37 times 10 to the 6 meters squared, 9.83 meters per second per second. There's a small correction that's applied because of the Earth is spinning. So we use 9.80 instead. As I said in class also, this does depend upon where you are, but it's certainly closer to 9.80. The correction that we apply to this small correction is closer to what we would observe here in Seattle.